This is Moby, I'll read my notes in a minute, but he was starting to talk to us here. He was starting to show off his vocalizations here. What? Woof. 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 What? He is huge. That head is, you got a big head. Look at that smile too. Look at that face. Okay, I'll go to his notes here. Maybe we'll get him to talk again. Oh, there we go. You are such a good boy. Oh, they said 4-year-old. So actually, I saw this one online. They did not, he wasn't rescue only. They had not contacted us. But when I saw him, you know, Malamutes aren't that easy to place. And I knew we could find a home for this one right away. So I contacted him. His original posting said, Moby is a big 4-year-old boy who loves snuggles. He loves playing with toys and already knows sit. Oh, this is their description. Malamutes are extremely intelligent dogs, so we believe he'll easily learn new tricks with the patient owner. Malamutes also, you have to be very consistent with them. Oh my goodness. Is he falling big, lean? That's a big dog to lean. Due to his size and breed, he does require a yard with a 6-foot privacy fence. If you think he's as handsome as we do and believe you could give him a great forever home, please meet him today. We don't know about the privacy fence. I mean, it's always a good idea. But I've had 2 very large male Malamutes that did fine in my 4-foot chain link fence. So they will escape like Huskies, but they're not as fixated on it as Huskies tend to be. Said he's current on all vaccination. He was found running loose with a small poodle mix. He has been temperament tested. He keeps getting his neck wrap off. They put like a big towel around their neck to keep him from, it was weird looking. I thought maybe he had an embedded collar and they had removed it when I saw the first pictures.
What was it to keep him from licking his
teeth? Yeah. So he's being medicated to not lick. Also has bleach burn on his testicles. You would think maybe that in a kennel or something, but they found. Anyway, they said he doesn't seem to like big dogs. He did live with a small dog, and they did confirm he's 110 pounds. Now, I told Leela here at the kennel when he was coming in that he supposedly wasn't good with big dogs. So she actually has him between 2 males, which isn't something I do, but she said they're both the easiest going ones as far as getting along with next door neighbors, and said he seems to be fine with them. So I'm not sure. I mean, usually a lot of times the males are far more likely to get along with other dogs than the females are in this breed. So I wouldn't necessarily rule that out, but he would absolutely need to meet any potential siblings. We did walk him by the cats, and I'll put that at the end, and he did not seem, tell us about it. Tell us all about it. Come on, he's got a big boyish bark too, don't you? You got a big deep voice like Henry did. Yeah. There's your big talker. Woof. 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 He wants to play, doesn't he?
Oh, he's really playful.
Oh, look at you. You're a...
How old he really was. He's yeah. Got nice teeth.
Yes, he does. I mean, I don't know that I would have guessed 4 either.
They look puppy.
Yeah, they look very clean from here. So we'll have our vet give a good guess as far as his age. I mean, we don't know how they do it at the shelter. What? Oh, my goodness. You are a big, bouncing baby boy, aren't you?
Yeah, but I'm holding him loosely.
Yeah, no, that tail is just going to town. So 2 of our very regular volunteers, Petey and Diane, went to pick him up. And they went to Mishawaka. Oh, bear with me one. And she wrote, Moby is safely at the kennel, and wowza, is he ever a great dog. When we took him out of the shelter building, Petey walked him around a bit, and he must have peed 5 times trying to mark everything in sight. He did the same with us when we took him outside here. But nothing inside. I mean, it's like as soon as he went outside, he pottied. He's a big boy, may need some leash work, but Petey said he doesn't pull any more than most of the dogs in rescue, regardless of size. When we got to the kennel, Petey took him for a walk. He went right over the grass to pee again. Not sure if that's an indication he's housebroken, but he did not mess in the car during the 2.5-hour ride. The shelter workers were so happy for him. They all came over to give him hugs when we left. He jumped right up into the car and laid down. Occasionally, he'd reposition himself for a different view, but he was such a good passenger. We stopped at Dairy Queen, and he got a pup cup. He took it gently from me and put it between his paws to lick the plastic cup clean. PD and I didn't finish our treats quite as quickly as Moby, and the only peep we heard out of him was while we were still enjoying our Dairy Queen, and his was already gone. He howled, very deep, deep voice, to let us know he'd like a bit of that. Oh, look at you. Oh, my heavens to Betsy. I gave him PD's plastic malt cup, and he again took it gently, put it between his paws, and licked out. Am I talking about pup cups? And licked out every last morsel. I gave him my paper blizzard cup, and that got a bit interesting. He licked up the easy stuff, then started shredding the cup to get to the bottom. I started to take the cup away from him, thinking he'd try and eat the paper. He gave me the look. So I decided it wouldn't be smart to get between a dog and his pursuit of vanilla ice cream. He continued to shred the cup, got every last morsel, but didn't eat any of the paper. Didn't growl or bare teeth when I reached out to take the cup. He just gave me a look. He is so very handsome and seems to have a great personality to go with the looks. This is a pretty appealing dog right here.
He really is.
Gorgeous. He looks like he's lost a few guard hairs. We don't know. That tail looks like it, you know, not as plumy as it probably should be given his coat. But you said he's a nice weight and everything?
Yeah, he's not fat or thin. He's a good weight.
He said, there's that tail. It's, I can wag it. He's just so happy. And as you could see in the video, it's like he just wants to romp around and play. So you'd need a big living room if this dog were romping around in it, wanting to play, or one where there's not as much to knock over as there is at my house. Hey, buddy. Hi. Hi. Look at that face. Look at that face. He's already been neutered. They did all the vetting. Really great to work with. They don't transport, but they gave him good care. They didn't want to release him from the shelter to us until he was medically released after his neuter surgery, which he is recovering from. Aunt Bev's going to give him a treat. Wonderful speak. Did you do paw? Did he give you a paw? Did I see that?
No, I didn't say a paw. Shay, he did that just now when I told him. Give me a paw.
He may know it then because, a lot, you know, when they know it, a lot of times it's like they'll work it to try. You are just a big...
Oh, there we go.
There we go. Good boy. Oh, you are just a big fluffy bear, aren't you? My goodness. My goodness. Hi. There's that tongue. There's that tongue.
Actually, it's kind of pale.
Is it? Well, I've been operated on. Hi. Hi. Can I come see your face? Here. Let's do the treat cam. Now, you are like a Malamute should be, wanting everything in sight to eat. Okay. Let's sit. Sit. Good boy. Shake. Give me a paw. Good boy. Awesome. Here we go. Oh, my heaven. Oh, you're too cute. There we go. Oh, hi. Hello. Pleased to meet you. I don't have any more treats, but...
I'm observing about his tongue. It's kind of...
Pain. Yeah, it is a little bit. Hi. Hi.
Are you anemic?
Look at you. Look at that big foot. You are a good boy. Oh, my heaven. Can we have a kiss? Can we have a kiss? Will you kiss that Beth? Can I have a kiss? There we go. He hasn't given you any kisses, has he? But no, he does the lean.
He does.
He said, I'm a very good leaner. Okay, so I don't think we're going to need too much more on this guy. This is Moby. This is Moby. I just got the toy out and he's talking to me now. What's that? With that. Give me that toy. Don't tease me with that toy. Look at him. He is just like a giant puppy.
Oh, he is. He acts like a puppy. That's
you sure do. Boy, you have a big deep. So cute.
Big vocal cords.
Yeah. I had the video off, but Bev just got him to go down on command with a treat. But like she said, that's an important thing in a dog this size. I'm going to stop this recording right now because he looks wonderful for pictures.
not see so much.
Okay, good idea, okay.
If the cats will cooperate. What about these cats?
Ouch! Oh, are you okay?
Yeah.
He seems pretty markedly disinterested in the cats, yeah.
Well, let's go out in the yard and pee.